Hello everyone, welcome to the fifth lecture of my Python series, operators in Python. So today's subtopics are basic operators in Python, use of int in printing repeated string, exponents, absolute value, precision handling in Python, and at last test your skills, in which one question is given on your screen and you have to answer it on the comment box. So let's start. Basic operators in Python. Operators are the constructs which can manipulate the value of operands. Suppose I am taking an example here. 4 plus 5 equals 9. So 4 and 5 are the operands, and plus sign is the operator. So 4 plus 5. So here plus sign is the operator. 4 multiply by 5 means my multiply sign is the operator. Plus adds two number, minus subtracts two number, multiply two number, divide symbol, divides two number, and modulo, which finds the modulo of two number. Modulo means the it means the remainder. Wait, I can show you this. Suppose I am taking a is equal to 6 and b equals to 3. So print a plus b. Let's run it. Can see the output 9. Now a minus b, 6 minus 3, 3. Now a multiply b means 6 multiply 3 equals 18. A divide b. So open view, you can see here. The output is in float. So to change into int, you can pass it into int function. And now modulo. So 0. Let me explain. If you don't know modulo, suppose I am taking 7. Now when we divide 7 from 3, what will be the remainder? 1. So this is the answer. Let's take 8. Now when we divide 8 by 3, what is the remainder? 2. Now you can see here the output 2. So use of int in printing repeated string. We can also print a string multiple times by using multiplication symbol. Okay, so suppose I am changing a to a string. Suppose hello, and here multiplication symbol. So let's run this code. You can see here the output is hello, hello, hello. Why? Hello, hello, hello. Why? Because I am multiplying the string 3 by 3. So the string will print 3 times. So you can see here hello, hello, hello. Now let's give a space between hello. After hello. Now hello, space, hello, space, hello. If you want to change the string, so I change the number of times 5. See the output. Hi. So now exponents. Exponents perform potential calculation on operators. Suppose I want to say 2 to the power 3. Okay, so first of all, change it. When we calculate 2 to the power 3, basically what we do? 2 multiply by 2 multiply by 2, and here just like it, to calculate the exponent, we put it 2 stars, so a star star b. So this means 2 star star 3, because the value of a is 2 and value of b is 3. So 2 star star 3, which means 2 to the power 3. And what is the value of 2 to the power 3? 2 into 2 into 2. So it outputs 8. Okay, so you can also change the value 2 to the power 4, it's 16. See the output, 16. So absolute value. Absolute value means how far a number is from 0. Example, 6 is, suppose I am taking a number 6. Okay, how much far is 6 from 0? 6 units. Okay, and how much far is minus 6 from 0? it's also 6 units. That's the absolute. Okay. Suppose I'm taking a equals minus 2. Now pass it in abs function. Can see the positive 2 and let's remove minus. You can also see this positive 2 means minus 2 is also 2 unit far from 0 and plus 2 is also 2 unit far from 0. So absolute function basically suppose removes the minus sign. Just precision handling. There are several functions to manage decimal variables in Python. So here you can see it here. Now we will in precision handling we have to work in decimals or float numbers. So sil function, floor function, trunc function, round function. So let's take an example. Suppose you are in a room. So the top of your floor, the bottom is floor and the top is ceiling. Just like I'm first importing math library in Python. If we want to import a library, we have to use import space library name. Now a equals, I'm taking a float 23.11. now print math dot seal a. So what will seal do here? Okay, so what is the greatest integer of integer value of 23.11? You can see the definition. Prints least integer greater than the number. Okay, so what is the least integer which is greater than this 23.11? integer means not float, 24. Okay, so let's print it, 24. Now for floor, in which we have to come down. Okay, so what's the greatest number? See here the definition. Greatest integer is smaller than the number. So what is the greatest integer which is smaller than the number? Of course 23. Now let's run 23. One more function which is trunc. Trunc basically removes the data after the decimal. Okay, so it will just remove this one, 0.11. so let's run 23. Now one more function, round. So suppose I am writing 23.11 and let's round it. See the output, 23 only. Now let's 49. It's 23. Okay, now let's change into 50 50 50. Now you can see the output, 24. So it is just rounding the integer. Okay, now test results here. It's a question. Don't forget to import math library. And if you like the video, please like, comment, and share my video. And don't forget to subscribe my channel.